You know, Christian, I loved that cube exercise. And the things that the students came up with was just wonderful. But, I mean, so what? I mean, it's you can't do anything with it. What's the use of it?
Well, the use is in helping students understand what it means to be a designer, what it means to actually design these affordances and the signifiers that...
Yeah, but I'm worried. So many designs I see are this wonderful, cute, and one thing, but they actually, nobody can understand them when they don't function very well.
Well, that's function is only part of it. I mean, you've got to bring in the other human elements, too. I mean, of course, there's meaning and function, and then there's usable, but it's also delightful.
So the real trick is to combine them. So we've been talking about things like affordance and constraints. And that makes it very functional and usable and understandable, but it's not necessarily interesting
and conceptual models, like how you actually know how to use something.
Yeah, but that doesn't, so what you're trying to tell me, the cube model is about making it more than that.
Yeah, and we're living in an era where this object, the phone, wasn't very much 10 years ago, wasn't much to talk about. It did things for you, it made phone calls, but now it's become a big part of your life. And a lot of that
is the enjoyment of using it.
Yeah, and designers have made it even delightful at times.
So what we have to do is we have to manage to combine the wonderful fun with the cube with the functionality of the other principles.
Yeah, and that's how you do design. It's about all these things. And you've now taken the first steps at designing the world yourself.